a lot of big fundamental differences. So probably the first one is simplicity. That's what solids have over liquids. With solid motors, it's basically a cartridge that you just slap into your vehicle and then you light an igniter underneath it and it goes. So it's a lot simpler in that respect. With liquid fuels, just a lot of plumbing you need. The propellants a lot of the times are cryogenic, which means they're liquid at much lower temperatures. And that creates a whole lot of issues with their storage and transportation and their use. So it's basically a lot more complex for a liquid fuel rocket. What makes the complexity of liquid fuel engines worth it, essentially, is their efficiency. For the same amount of propellant, you can get a lot more thrust out of that. You can get a lot further with a liquid fuel for the same mass than you can with a solid motor, essentially.
You would want to go with a liquid rocket engine for a couple of reasons. One is that they offer higher performance compared to solids. And that's a big deal. Like there's been a couple trade studies that I've seen just like from what NASA did and stuff. They tried getting to orbit using only solids, but they couldn't quite make it there with any usable amount of payload mass, if you would. So it was just really small. And so as soon as they switched over to liquids, it just kind of opened up. That's why all of the manned missions and stuff like that require liquid rockets. So the Saturn V and stuff.
So in terms of efficiency, LOX hydrogen is hard to beat. It's very efficient fuel. The thing is, hydrogen you have to keep very, very cold in order for it to stay cryogenic, and incredibly cold. So the advantage with methane is you don't have to keep it as cold for it to stay cryogenic, and there may be potentially large sources of methane on Mars, which is one of the reasons that they are incentivizing using methane for the Far Mars competition. Because if we can start utilizing methane more efficiently, like some companies like Blue Origin are doing, then it becomes a lot more feasible for us to become an interplanetary species, essentially.
So this is kind of a project that's based really in the future, so when we get to Mars, we'll be able to make more rocket propellant to do more missions around Mars. So whether that's manned missions or more robotic missions, but we can synthesize methane from the Martian atmosphere.
And that's really been a very recent development in the industry is liquid methane engines. NASA's worked on one called Morpheus. SpaceX is developing an engine called Raptor. So there's quite a bit of development recently in industry regarding Mars exploration, and that's where the Mars Society is really pushing that methane part. That really is the cutting edge of the aerospace industry right now, is the methane.